whitelist, blacklist. It doesn't have to be an either or choice. Guardicore supports both segmentation policy models and a combination of both. A whitelist model is about trusting no one, except the ones you have specifically approved. It's the common practice way to do segmentation and is the basis for the zero trust model. But as you know, in today's complex security environments, whitelisting is not enough. Think about blocking vulnerable protocols. Let's take the inherently insecure FTP as an example. You all know FTP can use high dynamic ports, which are naturally hard to whitelist. Guardicore enables you to block FTP by process everywhere on any port, and anyone trying to connect over FTP will be blocked. The good news is that with Guardicore Centra, you can use both. We actually see all our customers use both whitelist and blacklist. And the reason they do this is that it allows them to address any segmentation use case. Let's consider the following example. Blocking management protocols such as SSH and RDP unless they originate from a jump box. You've probably all tried it. Let's review the options. In a whitelist-only model, you will have to create thousands of allow rules, which will take you months. With Guardicore, you only need to create two simple rules, and it will take you less than a day. The first, that allows jump boxes to the production environment over port 22, and the second, that blocks everything else to production over the same port. Think two simple rules versus thousands. You want to learn more? Visit us at guardicore.com.